Hi there. I'm getting situated here. Sorry. I just wanted to jump on quick and show you, give me a sec here. One of the other kind of hacks that I've learned along the way. And it's using HTV to do my decals. So I just need to make sure my heat gun can reach over here and hopefully I can do this really quick. Cause I, literally just weeded these and I need to get them done. This works really great for glow in the dark HTV, and you just go through and you weed them. Now I do kind of like a layering thing. So I did a layer of epoxy in between. I did a green foil and now I'm doing this glow in the dark one top. This one's going to be a little bit different because I never did the holographic with the foil before. So we're going to try this out. I'm just going to do this really, really quick because the kids are right there. Yep. There's Blaze. Anyhow, you just weed it like regular, you cut it in reverse, and I hit it with my heat gun. I use electrical tape here in the corners just to make sure that it holds to the curve, and I hit it with heat for a little bit, turn my heat off, and then I kind of smooth it down with my fingers. Now, it will get really hot if you have your heat on too long, and you might hurt your little fingers. So, if you're super sensitive to heat, I would suggest using like an oven mitt or something like that, but all I'm doing is just heating it up. I have tried this with my heat press before, but since it is a flat surface, it doesn't work very well on a round tumbler. So this is what I do when I don't have the colored vinyl that I want. Plus, like, I used to do a whole lot of t-shirts. I don't really do t-shirts a whole lot anymore because I can't back them if people wash them wrong and they start to crack and peel after time. So I just have used my HTV this way. With the foil, I like to try and let it cool, so that I'm not like peeling it up and hoping for the best kind of thing and hoping it all stays. It doesn't look like it's good here at the head, so I'm gonna hit it one more time and then I'll switch to the Hocus Pocus. And then I wanna show you the cup that I did yesterday. Well, I started to do it yesterday with the geode. I've been kind of all over the place because life's been crazy, but slowly but surely I'm working through it all. So I think that that's going to hopefully be good enough, and I'm just going to let that sit and cool for a second while I do the Hocus Pocus one. And I have to also do some Stick Tight and Quick Coat next, but I'm not going to bore you with all that. I have a video on my YouTube if you want to learn more about that process, like if you are worried about like decals repelling or anything like that. Pretty much your answer is this Quick Coat and Stick Tight stuff from Counterculture. So here we go. Just smoothing it out. And hopefully this will be good to go because I need to get these wrapped up since Halloween is coming next week. And I want these people to be able to enjoy their cups, so I need to crank them out pretty quick. Okay, so that one can cool. I'm gonna try and peel this. Hopefully it will be nice to me and not fight me, but I think it's a really cool, no, it's totally peeling up already. So if you start to peel it and you see that it's starting to lift, you're not quite there and you need more heat. So you just keep doing it until it doesn't peel. The foil stuff's tricky though, because it can like give funny looks to it. Not like, if it gets peeled up a little bit, it looks funky. In my personal opinion, I'm gonna peel my electrical tape off. Hopefully we can start to ease off of this. Here we go. As I hit everything else, oh, her arm's not staying down. I have gotten to the point where like, I kind of cut my plastic if I need to, but for now we're just gonna hit her arm a little bit more and smooth it. And hope for the best here. Take it off over here. Hopefully my Hocus Pocus is good. Decals are super, super time consuming, and I love them because they like pretty much make a cup. But at the same time, like, I have to upload all the different designs, and sometimes the images that I get sent don't work right, and I have to like go searching for my own. And so it's a little tricky at times, and then you have to cut it, and then you have to weed it, and then you gotta hope that you don't fight it like this. Oh, we're getting there, Ursula. Almost. Let's see if we're good on this side yet. Yep, our arm's still sticking. So you heat it up and press it, and because you're working on stainless steel, it shouldn't take a whole lot of heat, but some of this stuff is like more resistant than others. And that was Blaze's skeleton. She's been carrying that around all day. It was her friend. She was dancing with it and hugging it and had to take it with us to Herman's earlier. It's a little creepy, but hey, whatever works, right? And Ursula is off, but then you're gonna wanna like press it and smooth it so you don't have any funky air bubbles.
No, I'm not shutting up yet.
She's gonna talk to you guys. So, that is Ursula. It's a little bumpy in some areas, so I'm probably gonna hit it with some heat and fix that. And then, sorry, my phone is working on dying.
I need my car!
Get down off the table.
I need my car here. And my skeleton.
Here's your skeleton. You don't need to stand on a chair on the table. And this is why I get interrupted 20,000 times in a day. It's because of Blaze. I love her, but I get interrupted. And that's pretty much it for how you put HTV on a cup. Looks a little rough, takes a little practice, but it gets better each time. So that's pretty much it. Oh, and the geode that I did yesterday, the dirty pour geode, this is what it's looking like now. Not even sure where I'm going to put the decal because it's really just pretty all around. So we shall see. I'm going to hopefully be able to coat this one tonight as well. So that's that. Thank you so much, guys.